The state government has passed new pool safety laws, but critics say they won't save any lives. Homeowners have 5 years to comply or face stiff fines.
These days, Oliver Bergman can jump in a pool and swim for his life. But when he was a baby, he nearly drowned.
Oh, it was just... I still think about it today. It was just that panic that comes over you.
He fell into a pool during a Christmas Day party.
You know, I just flew over a table and jumped into the water.
A split-second move that saved her son's life. Queensland is known as the drowning capital of the world, but now has some of the toughest laws in the world.
They're going to make sure that pools comply on an ongoing basis.
Fines will be tougher too. There'll be an on-the-spot fine of over $1,600 and another $16,500 for pool owners who continually refuse to comply.
But it's the 90-day leeway for homeowners to fix up an unsafe pool critics say is dangerous.
We'll be playing Russian roulette with the lives of Queensland children.
The first 90 days of moving into a new home are the highest risk factor.
There are a million pools in this state, many still unsafe. While this one once passed a safety check, neighbours' trees mean it now does not comply because a child can climb into the yard. At this house, the pool fence is a hazard.
And this gate doesn't close properly.
A wheelbarrow, large rocks and pot plants, easy for little ones to use as ladders. The new laws require mandatory inspections for all privately owned pools within 5 years, or earlier if a house is sold or leased. Portable pools and spas with a 300mm depth must also be fenced.
But the most important thing is to teach your children how to swim.
Lexi Hamilton-Smith, 10 News.